The Magic of Mexico, In the Footsteps of the Toltecs and Carlos Castaneda. Episode 1, The Mystery of the Basilica of the Virgin of Guadalupe. The books of Armando Torres say that in the territory of modern Mexico, there are various lines of practitioners, where a variety of art of the ancient Mesoamericans is maintained and developed. For example, the Jicuri Brotherhood, well known as peyoteros, damascleros, assistants, or veladores, flyers of the sacred pole, practitioners which follow the traditional lines of prehistoric dancers, canjeros. Similarly, magician healers, diableros, magician chupacabras, and many other magicians of open and closed line. At the beginning of our tour of Mexico, we met one of these canjeros, Grandfather Miguel. The mundane name is Miguel Angel, after Michelangelo Buonarroti, and the magical name is Itzlioxelotl, Obsidian Jaguar. Miguel told us a little bit about himself, about his line of sun dancers, and explained the actual origin of the image of the Virgin of Guadalupe, the basilisk which our bus was heading towards in the very start of our trip. Its magical name means obsidian jaguar in Nahuatl. The mundane name is Michelangelo because his mother adored Michelangelo Buonarroti, and that is why she gave him that name. Miguel has been in the Mixtec Toltec tradition on the red path of spiritual development for 20 years. Grandfather Miguel is a dancer dedicated to the sun, and his wife is a grandmother and is a dancer of the dances of the moon. The official version of the Catholic Church on the apparition of the Blessed Virgin of Guadalupe. On December 9, 1531, on Mount Tepeyac, where the cathedral is now located, an Indian boy, Juan Diego, saw the Virgin Mary in the form of a brunette woman. The Virgin Mary asked this carrier boy to transfer to the bishop a request for the construction of a Christian cathedral in this place. The bishop did not believe the boy. Then, Virgin Mary appeared again and asked the carrier boy to bring roses to the Catholic bishop. The boy brought roses, but when opening the cloak to show them, the bishop saw the imprinted image of a dark-skinned girl on the cloak. After that, the bishop believed in a miracle, and the Catholic cathedral was erected. Comments from Grandfather Miguel about the origin of this image and what it means. Juan Diego, who had a vision of the Virgin, was a colcator, which means talking eagle. After the fall of Tenochtitlan, they all fled to Cuitlahuan. The Toltecs and Aztecs did not want to accept the faith of the Spaniards, which was imposed on them. They had to choose between saving the people and converting them to the Christian faith and perish. Therefore, the Talking Eagle decided that we would accept their fate, but with our image. The image of the Virgin was created by the artist teacher Marco Cipactli, Marco Lizard in translation.
Marco Cipactli. Марко ящерица, да, в переводе.
It is necessary to experience this special feeling at least once to truly understand that the earth lives and is filled with such extraordinary power that it far exceeds all our ideas. The book The Wisdom of the Toltecs, Carlos Castaneda and the Philosophy of Don Juan, 1996, Klassen Norbert. When they brought the image to Bishop Juan de Zumarraga, he looked and said that it fit him. It's similar to the other images. Then he asked, what was the name that we were going to give this image? The Indians replied that we would call it Tononatzin. Tononatzin means Mother Earth in Nahuatl. We need 45 minutes. Will we have 45 minutes to visit the Basilica and get back on the bus? Well, it is now 10:45, and at 11:30 we will sit here again. Don Juan said thousands of years ago, sorcerers realized through visions that the earth is a sentient being, and its consciousness can act on the consciousness of people. The book, The Power of Silence, 1987, Carlos Castaneda. This church was built in honor of the Virgin of Guadalupe in 1535 by the Bishop of Zumarraga. And this building was built in 1976. It is more spacious and can hold more people.
Esta ya es de este siglo, del 1960, algo así, ¿no?
Part of our group climbed to the top of the hill where, according to legend, the Virgin appeared to the Indian Juan Diego. Now at that spot, there is a large Catholic church, and the most beautiful views open from the top of the hill. Only love for this magnificent creature can set a warrior spirit free. And freedom is joy, efficiency, and detachment from any obstacle. Tales of Power, 1974, Carlos Castaneda. This image shows how Juan Diego arrived and displayed the image of the Virgin on his cape.
Этом изображении нам представлено, как Сан-Диего
According to legend, some kind of miracle was requested to confirm that it exists. When he reached this hill, in December, he saw a rose bush bloom. Juan Diego collected these blooming roses in a cloak and brought them to the bishop. When the bishop opened this cloak, he saw the image of the Virgin of Guadalupe. Everyone around was amazed. Everyone recognized the Virgin of Guadalupe. This whole story was invented by the same bishop to baptize the Indians. We entered a very old church almost 500 years ago, where an image of the Mexican version of Guadalupe was located more than 200 years ago. That is, was he canonized in this way? He was canonized for having brought Christianity. In this altar, which is in front of us, the image of the Virgin of Guadalupe was here 200 years. And when a new church was built, it was moved from this building to a new one. And this building itself was built in the 1570s, half a millennium. Who is it? It's Juan Diego with the imprint of the Virgin of Guadalupe. We approach the complex where the image of the Virgin of Guadalupe is located on the first floor, and below it on travelators.
Dios Todopoderoso tenga misericordia de nosotros, perdone nuestros pecados y nos lleve.
She's in the center with a green cape under the cross. Juanaro's love is in this world, he said. He just hugged this huge earth, but since he's so small, all he can do is swim in it. But Earth knows that he loves her and cares for him. That is why Juanaro's life is full to the brim, and his fortune, wherever it is, will be abundant. Juanaro walks the paths of his love, and wherever he is full. Tales of Power, 1974, Carlos Castaneda. The ancient seers saw that the earth is inside a cocoon. This is what they saw. There's a ball, inside which is the earth. This ball is a luminous cocoon that contains the emanations of the eagle. Thus, the earth is a gigantic living being, subject to all the same laws to which we are subject. As soon as the ancient Toltecs found out about this, they immediately began to look for ways to apply the new knowledge in practice. As a result, one of the most developed categories of their magical practices arose, earth practices. The book Fire from Within, 1984, Carlos Castaneda. Discussion about the details of the bust of the image of the Virgin of Guadalupe. A belt with a bow symbolizes that a woman is pregnant. There's a legend in Mexico City that the image of the Virgin of Guadalupe is a coded message in which each symbol has its own meaning. A little digression. Now, on the left side, there is a church that was built in honor of San Juan Diego. The church was destroyed by an earthquake, only the facade remained. This is an image of the death hummingbird that decapitated Coyoloxauqui, who, according to legend, was supposed to kill Mother Earth. The last Aztec emperor, Cuauhtemoc, said that we have lost our sun, so the image of the Virgin of Guadalupe is in front of the sun. She covers the sun with herself, and that is why the rays flash behind the Virgin of Guadalupe.
Hello.
The black moon means that the dark ages are coming. But dark times does not mean that something is wrong. It is simply the absence of the sun, or less light. This happens after the equinoxes. For example, after the autumnal equinox, the days become shorter and the nights longer. The three flowers symbolize the three mountains, Texcoco, Tacuba, and Tenochtitlan. In ancient images, the mountains were drawn in the form of flowers, and to deceive the bishop, the mountains on the dress were also depicted in the form of flowers. Brief summary about the Mexican version of Guadalupe. The appearance of the Virgin of Guadalupe was a big deal between the Catholic Church, Hernan Cortes, and the leaders of the indigenous tribes. The Virgin of Guadalupe is not Saint Mary, but nothing more than Tonotzin, the Indian image of Mother Earth, the Mother Beginning. Thanks to such treatment, the Indians continued to pray to their gods, but formerly fell under the egregor of Catholic Church. The Virgin of Guadalupe is the most revered religious sanctuary in Mexico. The Catholic Church could not accept the name Tonatzin. As a compromise, the image's name was suggested by Hernan Cortes, who was a great admirer of the Spanish Virgin of Guadalupe. In the image, the Mexican Virgin of Guadalupe, Tonotzin, is pregnant, since the planet Earth is in constant pregnancy, giving birth to new forms of all living beings, and in the future it should give birth to the new sun. The belt with which it is girded speaks of pregnancy. The cape of the Virgin of Guadalupe does not represent flowers, but stars. From below, an angel-like creature with wings of different colors is not an angel, but an Indian Huitzilopochtli, a deaf hummingbird. Tezcatlipoca of the South, this is from Toltec Aztec mythology, who decapitated Coyolxochitl with a fire snake. The Virgin of Guadalupe stands on a crescent made of a black moon, and this moon is Coyolxochitl. According to mythology, she was supposed to kill the pregnant Earth. Coyolxochitl's head in the sky, this is the moon that lights us up. In the Wikipedia on the topic Virgin of Guadalupe, you will find a story about an Indian, Juan Diego Cuauhtlatoutzin, who supposedly met the Virgin of Guadalupe in the image of the Virgin Mary. This is a fiction that does not correspond to reality, invented to somehow fit this indigenous image into the Catholicism sown in Mexico. That is, modern Mexicans praying to their Virgin of Guadalupe, in fact take their prayers to Mother Earth. This earth, this world, for a warrior there can be no greater love. Only if you love this earth with an unwavering passion can you be free from pain, Don Juan said. A warrior is always happy because his love is immutable, and his beloved, the earth, embraces him and showers him with unimaginable gifts. Pain is for those unlucky who hate this earth, which shelters all living beings. Don Juan caressed the ground tenderly again. This sweet creature, who is alive to the last speck of dust and understands every feeling, calmed me down. He healed my pain, and finally, when I fully understood my love for him, he taught me freedom. She made me think about my own life and my own sadness, my own not knowing where to go or what to do. Tales of Power, 1974, Carlos Castaneda. In the following episodes,
él es el fuego, porque está en la Chicoatl, la serpiente es el fuego. Él es el agua, porque él se manifiesta como Tlaloc.
See video description. Episode 2, Where Gods Are Born, follows.